when we went down to Mom and Dad's over the summer, every once in a while, I would get an opportunity to preach at one of these little country churches. I'd get a chair and go find me a quiet place so I could practice my sermon. Well, I found a place out behind the barn, and I was just preaching, you know, bless God, you need to get old again, you need to get right with God. And here come a snake, big old snake, looked like probably just a little nothing snake, but it's big enough to get me to do a breakdance. I went and got me a tubaful, an 8-foot tubaful, and I commenced to beating that snake, and I beat his head off. I beat him till he wasn't moving on me. And I went back out, found me another piece of hay binding, little piece of rope, tied it onto that snake, went up to the trees, and served somebody some snake dinner. You know, it wasn't no time at all. Next time I looked up in the tree, I expected to see that snake swinging. But it is gone. Something was sure glad I was around. One time we were working out in the barn, and Dad told me, go plug this extension cord in. I said, where's the socket? He said, right up there on top of the horse's stall. So I went in there, climbed up. There was a snake laid right beside the electrical socket. I said, yeah, go plug the cord in. I don't know if he set me up or not, but I went and found a hole, something I could reach up, knock that snake off with. Well, he had a big lump in it, so I wanted to see what that lump was. Come to find out, it's a little baby bird. Dad said that was a chicken snake. I said, what in the world is a chicken snake eating a little baby bird? Well, he didn't eat no more baby birds. And I got busy. I couldn't find another piece of rope. I don't know what happened to that chicken snake, but I'm sure some raccoon or something got it. Snakes, they in danger, and they got around me.